Readings from Ludlam Parish Hall again. This is just a simple short little chair practice that I thought might be good since we do spend so much of our time sitting these days. So all you need this time around is just like any sort of comfortable chair, ideally without arms or sides, just with your feet comfortably on the floor. That just supports your whole body. Taking a few moments to just center ourselves here. Taking a nice deep breath. On an inhale. Expanding the ribs and the chest. And slowly exhaling. Just letting something go here. Just spending a few moments just turning inward here, connecting with the breath. And we'll begin with a few rounds of sun breath here. So on an inhale, bringing both arms up overhead. Exhaling, palms touch, and bringing the hands to heart center here. A couple more times, inhaling, arms up. And exhaling, palms touch, heart center. Once more, inhaling, arms up. And exhaling, palms touch at the heart center here, Anjali Mudra. So from here, we'll move just a little ways out, just to the edge of the chair for the time being. So still feeling supported underneath the sit bones and keeping the feet on the earth here. Then taking hold of the bottom of the chair with your right hand, bringing the left arm overhead, finding a side bend here. Inhaling, both arms up. And exhaling over towards the left, so taking that bottom of the chair with that left hand, reaching the right arm overhead and off to the side. And we'll do that once more. So over to the right, on an inhale, lengthen. Exhale, just stretching that left side of the body. Lengthening back through to the center, and then over to the left. And from here, we'll bring both hands to the knees here and just begin to take some seated cats and cows. So on an inhale, lifting the chest and sternum, bringing the shoulder blades together down the back. Exhale, rounding the spine, gazing towards the belly here. And just taking a few of these at your own breath, your own pace. Just linking with the inhale and the exhale. And coming back to a neutral spine. And we'll just gently take a twist here. So placing that right hand onto the left thigh, bringing that left hand just to the back of the chair. Inhaling, lengthening the spine. Exhaling, twisting. Inhaling, lengthening. Exhaling, twisting. One more breath, inhale and lengthen. Exhale, twist. And coming back through to the center, and we'll do that on the other side. So placing your right hand on the back of the chair towards the right side here, left hand to the outside of that right thigh. Inhale, lengthen the spine, exhale, twist. Just staying with the breath here. coming back through to the center, just using the legs here a little bit. So on an inhale, lifting that right leg, straightening it if you're able, if not, just as much as you can. And then lowering it back down. Do that a few more times with that right leg. Inhaling, lifting. Exhaling, lowering. Inhaling, lifting. Exhaling, lowering. Good. And then we'll play with that on the left side here. So inhaling, lifting. Exhaling, lowering. Inhaling, lifting. Exhaling, lowering. Once more, inhaling and lifting. Exhaling, lowering. Good. And from here, just taking a few shoulder rolls here, releasing some tension in the neck and the upper back. First in one direction, and then the other. From here, we'll stand up and we'll come to the back of the chair. So you'll always be holding on to the chair here. We'll be standing and doing a few postures here, but you always have the chair for support, and that's important to note here. So from here, holding on to the back of the chair with your left hand, taking your right leg so that it faces straight to the side here. And then taking your left leg back to a warrior two or to a lunge position. And then just bringing that right arm alongside the ear, bringing a warrior variation here. And then beginning to straighten that front knee, lower that right hand, bringing it to the back of the chair here and pivoting on that right foot, and then having your left foot face straight ahead as well. And we'll find that lunge on the other side. And then coming back through to the center here. And we'll do that once more, lunging towards the right. Keeping that knee over the ankle and using the chair for support here. And beginning to straighten that knee, I will add a version of pyramid pose here, bringing your right hand to your right hip. Inhaling and lengthening, exhaling, folding forward. Doesn't have to be too far. And always having the chair here for support. Inhaling, coming back up. And then finding our lunge position on the other side here. Pivoting that left foot so that it's in parallel with the back of the chair here. And coming into your lunge on your left leg here, making any adjustments as needed. Beginning to straighten that knee, shift the hips backward slightly, and then reach the torso forward, bringing that left hand to left hip, finding a variation on pyramid pose here. Sending the breath to that left outer hip if need be, just noticing anything your body's trying to communicate to you as we come back up. And then pivot both feet so that they're facing straight ahead now, the same direction of the chair, and walk or heel toe them in a little ways so that we're standing straight up behind the chair once more. And then we'll come to the right side, still holding onto the chair with your left hand. And then just beginning to shift the weight into that left leg here, and bringing the sole of that right foot maybe here to the ankle, maybe up into the calf, or maybe just keeping the ball of the right foot on the mat here on the floor beneath you. I'm finding a variation of tree pose. So depending stay right here. Maybe you come into baby tree, keeping that forearm against the upper body. Or maybe you extend that right arm, fully growing branches on your tree here. And just taking a moment of gratitude for what trees bring us each season. Continuing to breathe. And then slowly release. Taking a moment to shake out the legs here. And then walking around the chair over to the other side. This time beginning to shift the weight into that left leg here. Hand can come to the hip and bringing the sole of that opposite leg, maybe, again, maybe to the ankle, maybe to the calf, or maybe just keeping the ball of that foot on the earth where it feels secure. Always holding on to the chair and finding your variation, lifting that left arm and finding some length here in our tree pose, Vrikshasana. And then slowly releasing. Taking a moment to shake out both legs here. And then coming back to our chair, finding our seat once more. And then we'll work with the arms and the upper back a little ways here. So on an inhale, bringing both arms in front of you, and sliding the right arm underneath the left. Maybe the palms touch here, maybe they don't. If they don't, just touching opposite shoulders is fine too. Or just maybe trying to play with this variation of eagle arms here. Just noticing the space between the shoulders, sending the breath there, creating some space between the shoulder blades. Elbows. They don't have to be very big. And then in the other direction, just creating space in the upper back here. And releasing the hands. Come to the other side shortly and finding just a few shoulder rolls here. And easing some tension. And then bringing the hands parallel with the shoulders once more, putting the right arm underneath the left arm underneath the right. And then finding this posture in the other direction. Just again, once more, sending the breath between the shoulder blades. And then beginning to find just some small circles with the elbows here. And then the other direction. And releasing the hands here back down to the thighs. Maybe just a couple more cats and cows. Just creating space between the vertebrae. And then settling back in towards the back of your chair here, feeling supported so that your back is supported by the back of the chair. Placing the hands on the thighs here. And just coming back to the breath once more as we began. Maybe closing the eyes here for our seated relaxation. And then bringing the hands to heart center. And as the yogis say, the light in me honors the light in you. Thank you so much. See you again soon. Namaste.